Alright, Father Juan, first and foremost, like give all praises and glory and honor to
Yahweh Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Akarkadash.
Shalom to the elders and great male songs of Christian word, truth, and sincerity. And shalom to the Akim, scattered to the world, and the Christian word, truth, and sincerity as well, too. And I say shalom to the Akim out there. Out here, another day on this Monday, May the 29th, 2023, at 2:09 p.m. on this Monday afternoon. So, while you have Ashim out there, you're giving us an opportunity and chance to come out here to do so. And out here on the highways and byways, the chief place in our course, the loud days as well, too. And this is the book of Luke, chapter 21, verse 25. It says, and there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars upon the earth, reservations for the blessed, and the seas raised up. Right, so that's what we're seeing. You know, we're seeing the uprise and the uproars of the world. You know, this reservations. Just like you had that protest over there in that area with the Serbian community over there, tension stirring up over there. And then you had the recent deployment of those NATO troops over there. But I just did a lesson on that when I was on the bus, saying I was about to come over here in Tunisia, I was surviving, you had that protest going on over there as well, too. While you still have the recent protests, like I did a lesson on that day before yesterday, the protests over there in France, of the pension reform and stuff like that. So that shows you a prime example of uprise of the uprising of the world, of the discretion of nations, complexity in the seas where it won't. That's what we are seeing, and that's what we are experiencing in the last days, So, hey, it's going to continue to be uncertainty of the discretion of nations, the uprises and the seditions as well, too. Just like we're seeing with the Israel-Palestine situation, taking place. Like I mentioned again, those protests going on over there in the Serbian community, Just like the previous, you had clashes between, because they've been having the protests, I would say, since Friday and all the way to Monday now, because, NATO had deployed to NATO troops down there to this the situation to calm tensions down. But, hey, you had those Serbians roused up over there doing protests and stuff like that, Because they was doing those recent protests in those four different towns in that area over there with the Serbian community. And, they was kind of opposing that, one of those elected mayors in those four different cities. One of them was like Albania of the city. And the Serbian community, they was opposing that of them being the new elected mayor in those different four different towns. They had protests that lasted over the weekend from Saturday to Sunday. From Friday and Saturday all the way to Sunday and all the way into now, So we're seeing a new fresh clash of protests over there in that area. So that shows a prime example of uprising and uproars of people who are in sedition among men. Just like it says in 2 Kings 15 and verse 16, they should not regard their kings nor their princes. They should stand in the course of their action. And that's what's taking place in the world today, So these citizens, they highly oppose these new elected officials that's in power, in the power seat, And they highly oppose that. Recent ones that was in there and the ones that have been in there for quite a while. So that's why that's why you have these citizens in these respective countries are in the uproar of that, Just like the pension reform down there, a pension reform over there in Paris, those protests are starting to clash up once again. A new escalation of those protests as of day before yesterday. We've seen what's going on down there in Sudan, even though they're under a ceasefire. So I believe the United States and Saudi Arabia called for an extension of a ceasefire, I believe, But hey, even if they do extend the ceasefire, which is a current ceasefire right now, which is about to be up very soon, I believe another additional 7 days was taking place like a couple of days ago. They was able to have an agreement on the ceasefire on both sides of the armies over there down there in Sudan. But you still got continual escalations going on in that region. So that shows of these seditions and uprisings and uproars of people in the world is going to continue to increase and show forth in the United States. So that's why I'm going out to 21 and 25 of the discretion of nations for complexity. I'm going to bring out the second Ezra, chapter 15. 15, number 16 as well, too. So this leads into major events, global events that we are witnessing and experiencing in our world today. You know, these are the signs and times that we are in. You know, that leads up into these biblical signs. You know, that's why the men of the Lord, we are consistently being on our watch. We are discerning the times and we're measuring the times now, so more than ever, you know, in the latter days, you know. As we move forward and progress on, moving forward to this prophecy is about to be fulfilled, and moving forward soon come an increasing of these different signs. We are being on our watch now, so more than ever, you know. I'm gonna bring up the second Ezra. Ever growing up these biblical signs that leads into major prophecies, you know. prophecies that's going to come to pass, they're going to be fulfilled as well, too, and continue in person of these other signs now, so more than ever. That's why we are discerning the times, we are measuring the times, like I mentioned here previously. This is 2nd Ezra chapter 9, verse 2. Then thou shalt understand it is a very same time when the highest will begin the visible world, which he made. Right, just like you had that recent earthquake over there in Colombia. I believe it was in the northern part of Colombia. That was a magnitude of a 6.6 earthquake. So I did a sit-down lesson on that yesterday, you know, especially with the recent earthquakes over there in the Panama and Colombia border. That was a magnitude of a 6.1 to 6.2 earthquake. And then you've been having those recent earthquakes over there in London, of South Africa and that region over there. Hey, that was like a magnitude of a 6.5 or 6.6 earthquake, you know. Then we've been having those recent earthquakes over there in Indonesia, those recent earthquakes in Northern California, multiple earthquakes over there. You know, these recent tornadoes, these recent earthquakes, these landslides, these floods, that historical storm that hit, that tropical storm, that was the strongest in a long time. It was the strongest storm so far this year that happened over there in Guam, I meant to say. And it recently happened over there in Bangladesh, Guam as well, too. Hey, so that shows in prime examples that the Heavenly Father is going to continue to visit this earth with these increasing strongly life-threatening weather conditions, you know. And that's what we've been seeing as of late so far in the year 2023. So once the Heavenly Father visits this earth, you know, he's about serious business. He's not to be messed around and played, you know, because he's a strong power, you know. Of only true living power, which is Yahweh. That's his true name in the ancient Hebrew, Yahweh of Israel, you know. And this is 2nd Ezra chapter 9, verse 3. It says, therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars in the people world, right? That's what we're seeing. We're seeing earthquakes and uproars in the people world. You know, uprisings and uproars in the people world. So we're going to continue to see that increase now, so more than ever, you know. This is 2nd Ezra chapter 9, verse 4. The Apocrypha of the Holy Scriptures, and it reads, then thou shalt well understand the Most High Yahweh thy power spake of these things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning. Right, from the beginning that the Heavenly Father spoke of these signs that was going to occur in the latter days. That's what we're saying. We're going to continue to see that and witness and experience that in the latter days, you know, in these modern day times that we are in. That leads into the increase of the signs of the signs of the times that we are in. Now, so second Ezra chapter 9 verse 5, for like all that is made in the world, that a beginning and an end is never been right. So beginning and an end is being manifested. That leads into the increase of biblical signs that we are witnessing and experiencing in the latter days, in these current times that we are in. These major events, global events, and so the increasing of these prophecies that's about to be fulfilled very soon. We get closer and closer to that. That's why we're living out the book of Revelations now, so more than ever, you know. That's why we are discerning the times, the measurement times, the machine, except too, of these increasing global biblical signs. The 2nd Ezra 9:5, for like all that is made in this world, and at the beginning of the end, it's manifest, right? So the beginning of the end, it's being manifest. That means it's in these other signs, the signs of time. Six, Roman, and all his bands, the house of Oakmore, and all his echo there. But they haven't had a last attack that Israel defense was firing on missiles over there in the Syrian part of Damascus, I believe. Either Aleppo or Syria, you know. The last attack was like May the 2nd of this month. Now, the latest one as of yesterday, you know, over there in the Damascus area, you have the Israeli defense force firing off the target missiles at those facility areas over there, which is backed by pro-Iranian, you know. So that's why you got a lot of increased activity down there, like I've been mentioning previously. You know, I want to mention again, you got the Russian army down there, you got the Syrian army down there. You got Hezbollah, which runs down there. And of course, they have Iranian force. And the Iranian rebels have got pushed down there as well, too. So you got to continue increasing border conflict down there in Syria and the borders of Israel, which is the Israeli defense force firing off missiles over there in Syria. Now, so more than ever. And there was a news article came out, not did a sit down lesson on it, I was saying about 10 minutes ago. Saying that Iran wanted to upgrade Syria's nuclear capability, you know, even though they have air defense nuclear capability to intercept missiles, or the IDF, which is the Israeli Defense Force, continue firing off missiles over there in Syria, you know, because Iran look at the Syrian army as brothers, you know, he look at them as Syrian army brothers, so he want to help them develop more upgradable air defense nuclear capability to continue to this, you know, to go against the attacks from the Israeli Defense Force. So, hey, that's going to be a continued increase in hot zone area down there, you know, because you got Hezbollah, pro-Iranian groups, you know, the Syrian army, and the Iranian Revolutionary Guard groups, you know, they all teaming up together as of recently, you know, going against the Israeli Defense Force, you know. So, Russia is definitely going to be a guard to Iran, in Turkey, in Ethiopia, in Libya as well, too. So that's going to be a continued increase in hot zone area down there in the Middle East, even though we are so used in the customs or period tensions in the Middle East. Hey, but those escalations are going to keep on continually stirring up, you know. So definitely Russia is going to be a guard to those nations, Iran, Turkey, and Ethiopia, which is the Kushites of Islam. So that Ezekiel 38 chapter verse 39 is definitely coming into full fruition as we can see. So it's going to be a continued increase in hot zone area down there in the Middle East, especially with in between the borders of Israel, Syria, Iraq, Lebanon, and Jordan as well too. You know, so all those going to be a continued increase in hot zone areas. You know? Russia is definitely going to be a guard to Iran, especially down in Syria. You're going to have continued increasing escalations between the Turkish army versus the Kurdish army. Then you're going to have a lot of continued activities from the Russian army, from the United States army, from the Syrian army, the pro-Iranian groups, Hezbollah, you know, the Houthi rebels down there as well, too. So it's going to be an on and off increasing escalations down there in the Middle East. So more than that, you know. And this is the book of Isaiah, chapter 17, verse 1. And it says, the burden of Damascus, behold, Damascus is taken away from being a city, and it shall be a growing heap. Right, that shall be a growing heap. That's why you continue to see, like I've been mentioning again previously, and I want to mention and reiterate that again. Hey, while you have the Israeli Defense Force firing off missiles over there in Syria and different parts of Syria as well too, you know. So hey, Damascus is being taken away from being the city because you got a lot of nuclear escalations and tensions and war-like tensions over there in that area, you know. So that's why it's going to be a continual hot zone area down there in Syria. Definitely Aleppo of Syria, Damascus of Syria, central Syria, southwestern part of Syria, and eastern Syria as well too. So while you got those armies and factions down there in that area, so it's going to be a non-stop continued increasing cross-border conflict and clashes down there in the Middle East now, so more than ever. So Russia is definitely going to be a guard to Iran and Turkey and Ethiopia and Libya as well too, you know.
like I brought out Isaiah 17:1, hey, Damascus is being taken away from being a city. It's going to be a ruined heap. And that's what we are witnessing and seeing now, you know. And I'm going to bring out that Matthew 24:6. So, yeah, hey, these wars and rumors of wars are definitely heated up, you know. And this is Matthew 24:6. It says, and ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. Right, because the end is not yet. It's going to continue to increase and show forth now some more than ever in the latter days, you know. Just like you had this recent signing of, I believe it was Poland, and South Korea and Poland, they signed a $137 million nuclear arm deal, you know. And I believe that recently deployed more nuclear capability to Ukraine as well, too, you know. So while you got that Russian Ukraine heating up over there, hey, that's what we're seeing, you know. Then, just like South Korea and Poland, like I mentioned again, that announcement just came out. I did a sit-down lesson on that as well, too, earlier today. And that shows you, hey, nuclear military spending is at an all-time high. Just like over there in the South China Sea area, tensions are continuing to escalate. I believe the United States recently deployed it. But I believe it's an unofficial announcement. I don't know for sure if it's official, but it's an official announcement. I did a sit down lesson on that as well too. That, you know, I believe this state of missiles as part of this military aid package, that the United States sent to Taiwan over there. I believe it was like 500 million that they recently announced, you know. So that's like 500 million in military aid assistance and the state of missiles that they recently deployed over there in Taiwan. That the United States assists in Taiwan, which, you know, the continued relationships and military cooperation between Taiwan and the United States just continue to increase, unofficially increasing allies between the United States and Taiwan. So, you know, that kind of infuriates China even more and more and more. So, you know, China still look at Taiwan is still part of them. We still got that one China policy, you know, even though Taiwan have its own self-governor island. They had separated from the mainland China since 1949, if I'm not mistaken, you know. So that's going to stir up more escalations and more tensions, you know. So the United States is going to do whatever it takes to protect Taiwan from China invading Taiwan. So, hey, that's a prime example of the Matthew 24:6 of the nation shall rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom. Wars and rumors of wars. So that's what we are continuing to see now, so more than ever, you know. And especially what's going on down there in the Indo-Pacific region, hey, you're going to have continued escalations down there as well, too. Island, border territory islands, claims on those islands down there in that region, you know. Just like the United States recently signed that military cooperation deal. That kind of stirs up even more tension with the United States and China now, so more than ever. Because you got Indonesia, Malaysia, and other Asian countries down there trying to have territorial claims on those islands down there in those territories, not too far from the South China Sea. And China is bullying those nations, you know. And the Philippines, they said, hey, we have something to do about that. Hey, we're going to claim one of those islands down there as well, too. So you got a whole lot of nations down there escalating over a territorial island down there not too far from the South China Sea. And China been a top bully of that. That's why you're seeing the military deployment and the nuclear cooperation between the Philippines and the United States going against China. Beijing and Washington and China and the United States, you know, they still clashing with one another. I believe it was a news article, I did a sit down lesson on it from RT.com, and it was saying that, you know, United States trying to do some type of dialogue or some type of sit down, you know, so they could have some type of meeting between the armies of Beijing and China as well, too. Hey, China and Beijing, they
they have rejected those calls. They don't want no dealings with the United States of its military, of its military armies, you know. So the armies of Beijing and China, they don't want no dealings with the United States armies or of its allies, you know. So that shows you, hey, they rejected that and they haven't received, they have not responded back to that. So that shows you that, hey, that's a prime example of Matthew's 24:6. The wars and rumors of wars, you know. And sooner or later, it's going to be an escalating of increasing of war between these nations, you know. That's why it's heating up down there in the Indo-Pacific region and the South China Sea, right along the Taiwan Strait. As Taiwan is might be getting closer and closer to being invaded by China, invading Taiwan, and the United States will have to step in off that, you know. So that shows a prime example of our wars and rumors of wars, you know, now so more than ever. And not too long ago, I believe Lindsey Graham, which he's a Republican, Edomite, you know, he made that suggestion, I believe it was like a couple weeks ago, like a month ago, you know, due to the recent increasing of escalations between China and Taiwan, you know, and the United States assisting to protect Taiwan of a potential invasion from China, China invading Taiwan. And, you know, Lindsey Graham said a suggestion that, hey, they might have to send their troops down there to go to war with China, potentially getting closer and closer to Taiwan. So that's another prime example of those escalations are going to continue to stir up down there, you know, and everything. And then there was another news article that came out saying that the nuclear presence from China is getting closer to the South China Sea. They have crossed the Grand Line right along the Taiwan Strait, you know. So that shows you that China is getting closer and closer now, so more than ever, to invading Taiwan. So that shows you, hey, wars and rumors of wars are heating up. Just like the Russia-Ukraine situation. I believe it was the largest shows you that the Russia-Ukraine situation is going to continue to escalate now, so more than ever. That's another prime example of wars and rumors of wars right there, you know. So, hey, this is going to continue to increase now, so more than ever. Just like the North Korea versus South Korea, Japan, and the United States. Just like recently, as of May 25th, you know, hey, the South Korea and the United States did its largest military exercise drill. And I believe it was another news article as well, too. China, I think Tokyo criticized North Korea from their using their military satellite spy thing. And Tokyo look at that as a provocation of North Korea developing and launching more airstrikes closer to their area. Let's keep this in mind, while North Korea have been launching off their missiles as of late, definitely so far in the year 2023, you know, even though they kind of cooled down a little bit, but they're going to stir that up once more, you know, because as of recently, you know, you had North Korea been firing off and testing their upgradable short-range ballistic missiles, hypersonic, in advance hypersonic ballistic missiles over there right along the eastern part of eastern part of there in Japan, and right along with the Korean Peninsula as well too. So that shows you that, you know, it's going to be continue increasing escalations over there in that area, you know, the eastern part of Japan, right along with the Korean Peninsula as well too, with the North Korea versus the United States, South Korea, in Japan, those escalations are going to continue to stir up now, so more than ever, you know. So that's another prime example of Matthew's 24:6 as well, too. You know, wars and rumors of wars, you know. So what's going on down there in Sudan? You still got heavy escalating fighting down there in that region, you know. Now, so more than ever. So that's going to continue to stir up now, so more than ever. What's going on in the Middle East as of lately as well too. So all those are going to be a continued increasing hot zone area. So all
examples of the latest nuclear escalations that I've been mentioning about, and that's going to continue to stir up now so more than ever, because we are living in those times of increasing of our wars and rumors of wars, nation against nation and kingdom against kingdom. That's what we are saying. I'm going to go to Matthew 24:7, and this is Matthew 24:7. For nation shall rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilence and earthquakes in diverse places. Right, so the nation should rise against nation, the kingdom against kingdom. This is what we are witnessing. This is what we are experiencing in a lot of ways, you know. So, hey, that Middle East tension going on down there, that's going to be a continual hot zone area down there. What's going on with the Russia-Ukraine situation, that's going to be a continual hot zone area over there as well, too. What's going on with the South China Sea and the Taiwan Strait, that's going to be a continual hot zone area down there as well, too. Going on over there in the Indo-Pacific region, and that's going to be a continual hot zone area of nuclear escalation, you know. So the escalations between Russia and the United States is at an all-time high. That's why you've been seeing military spending at an all-time high since World War II. Hey, we've been seeing military exercise trainings at an all-time high, you know, from the year 2022 all the way to the year 2023. So this is what we're entering into. Hey, the war drums are drumming up now so more than ever, you know. As nuclear escalations and Armageddon has been getting closer to that in the Valley of Jehoshaphat, or Yahweh's decision is going to sit and judge all the nations round about. As soon as they gather all they self down there in the Valley of Jehoshaphat, which is down there in the Middle East, you know. So that's why, as of recently, right down there in the South in the Saudi Gulf region, in the Dragons of Arabia, and you start to see that Arabian Brotherhood starting to click up with one another once again, right along with the Persians, because you know the Persians, they are the Elamites. That's their biblical nationality. And the Arabs, they are mixed multitude. They are the Ishmaelites, you know. So yeah, hey, this is what we are witnessing and experiencing. So this is that time of season that we are in. Of course, you know, the wars and rumors of wars are going to continue to heat up now some more than ever. And this is what we are out here prophesying about. Of the soon to come of these increasing biblical signs, of the signs of the times that we are in modern day times. Everyone, these global events, these major events that we are witnessing, experiencing the world today in many different categories, hey, we're going to continue to see that increase now some more than ever, you know. I'm going to bring out that Ecclesiastes, the third chapter as well, too. Before I bring that out, bring out that Matthew 24:8, go to the next verse. And this is the book of Matthew 24:8. It says, all these are the beginning of sorrows. Right, we are in those stages of beginning of our sorrows. And soon to come of growing up these major events, global events, major events that leads into the biblical signs that we are in a lot of days, you know. Now I'm going to bring out the Ecclesiastes, the third chapter. This is the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 3:1. And it says, to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under heaven. Ecclesiastes 3:2. It says, a time to be born and a time to eat, i.e., and a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. Ecclesiastes 3:3, and it reads for the Holy Scripture. And a time to K-I-L-L, and a time to heal, and a time to break down, and a time to build up. Verse 4, Ecclesiastes 3:4, and it reads for the Holy Scripture. And a time to weep, and a time to laugh, and a time to mourn, and a time to dance. Verse 5, Ecclesiastes 3:5, and a time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together, and a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embrace. Ecclesiastes 3:6, a time to get, and a time to lose, and a time to keep, and a time to cast away. Ecclesiastes 3:7, and it reads through the Holy Scripture. And a time to win, and a time to sow, and a time to keep silent, and a time to speak. Right, so we are in the time to speak. Like the Scripture says, my prophet should not be backed into a corner no more. So, hey, we're out here on the highways and byways, the chief place of concourse. Prophesying about the increasing of the wars, peoples, and the pestilence. Just like you read in Jeremiah 28:8. Our forefathers back then prophesied against great countries and great kingdoms of war, people, and pestilence. This is where we are out here in modern day times, prophesying about the continued increase.
resurrection of the wars and the pestilence in the latter days. And I'm going to Isaiah 13 and 17 as well, too. And this is the book of Isaiah, chapter 13, verse 17. It said, "Behold, I will stir up the beast against them, which shall not regard silver, and as for gold, they shall not delight in it." Right, so you have our Shemal Shai is going to stir up the beast against the virgin God of Babylon. So like I mentioned again, I want to rephrase that again. Hey, nuclear escalations between the United States and Russia is at an all-time high. Just like recently, a month ago, you had Russia launching a advanced ICBM missile, issuing out that warning to the United States. Because Russia, they got more nukes than the United States. China and the United States. I mean, China and Russia combined, they got more nukes than the United States. So, hey, Yahweh Shemal Shai is going to stir up the beast against the virgin God of Babylon. That's why a nuclear escalation between the United States and Russia is at an all-time high. And this is the book of Luke, chapter 21, verse 9, in the Greek Holy Scripture. It says, when you should hear of wars and commotions, right, that's what we hear, increasing wars and commotions between the different nations and different kingdoms around the world. Nuclear escalations at an all-time high, you know. And I'm going to read again, Luke 21 and 9, but when you should hear of wars and commotions, be not terrified of these things must first come to pass. Right, so the men of the Lord are not going to be troubled or terrified of these signs. That's going to be fulfilled very soon. That's why the end is not yet, end by end by, you know. Going to continue to grow and show forth in the latter days. That leads into the wars and rumors, nation against nation, kingdom against kingdom, as they cross reference scripture, you know, in Matthew 24, 16, verse 7, I wrote the paraphrase of those cross reference scriptures, you know. So, hey, the nuclear escalations are going to continue to increase between these different nations, you know, and different kingdoms now, so more than ever, you know. And this is Luke 21 and 9, I'm going to read it again for edification's sake. It says, but when you should hear of wars and commotions, be not terrified, for these things must first come to pass, but the end is not yet by end by, right? It's not the end just yet. It's going to continue to increase and escalate now some more than ever. So, wars and commotions between the nations and different kingdoms. It says, this is the book of Luke, chapter 21, verse 10. Then say he unto them, nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. Right, just like the same scripture in Matthew 24 and 7. Of the nations rising up against nations and different kingdoms as well, too. You know? I'm gonna go to verse 11. And this is the book of Luke, chapter 21, verse 11, and here's the Holy Scripture. And great earthquakes shall be in diverse places. And pestilence and famines and sights and great signs shall there be forever. Right, so we're going to continue to see the increasing high magnitudes of earthquakes in diverse places. The pestilence, the plagues, the locusts, and etc. These chariot cycles, those are the chariots of the Heavenly Father. Those are the chariots Yahweh of Israel, you know. Now, so more than ever, that means that there's an increasing local signs that we are going to continue to see in the latter days. So we're going to see some unbelievable things that we never experienced and see in the latter days. So we're going to see these things now, so more than ever. That leads up into the increasing biblical signs. You know, so that's why we're the man of time jealousy in itself, the man of the watch. But he's increasing biblical signs. That leads into the increasing prophecies that's about to be fulfilled. And these global events as well, too, right along with the biblical signs. So we're going to see some unbelievable things that we haven't witnessed experience in the last days. You know? And we're going to continue to see more signs in many different categories as well, too. So we're going to continue to see that historical rage of these chariot sites, which the people call UFOs of this world. You know, we call those flying, identifying flying objects. And those are the chariots of Yahweh of Israel. Right? And I'm going to bring out Isaiah 29, 6 as well, too. And this is the book of Isaiah, chapter 29, and verse 6. Thou shalt be busy of the Lord of hosts with thunder and with earthquake and great noise and storms and tempest and the flames of our fire. Right, so we're going to continue to see the increasing of earthquakes in diverse places. The landslides, the mudslides, the floodings, the earthquakes, etc. You know, and these wildfires and these droughts. It's like the recent droughts over that Euphrates River. And that's the signs, of the times that we are living in. So we're going to continue to see these different weather-like we are living in the modern days of Noah, you know, because people were eating and drinking and giving into marriage, you know. And when I was walking past, as I got through with the lesson and everything, I got through the camp and stuff like that, then I had a scoffer. I don't know if she could you right. You know, she was saying she was walking past me when I was on my phone and stuff like that. And she was saying that, so you think the Bible's going to save you, you know. Like the scripture says, the God of this world hath blinded the minds of other people. They have blinded our nation and other nations as well, too. So like the scripture says, in the latter days, going to have scoffers and mockers walking out their own lusts, you know. What appeases them, what appeases them in their flesh and stuff like that, you know. Right, they're going to despise them. Like it says in 2 Timothy, hey, they're going to despise all those that are good. You know, they're going to think that us prophesying and speaking about good things and righteousness and going against evilness, they're going to think that's weird and awkward, you know. So this is the time that we are going to soon now still more than ever living in, you know. So that 2 Timothy, the third chapter, is definitely coming to full fruition. It's definitely showing that in the latter days, you know. I just want to add a note to that, because you had a Judite scoffing sister, you know, walking past me and stuff like that after I had gotten done with camp yesterday, and then they had some type of event that took place yesterday, you know. I just want to, you know, add a note to that. So that's a prime example. We're going to have scoffers and mockers in the last days walking after their own lust. So, hey, they're going to say, hey, you teaching the Bible, that's weird, that's crazy, that's dangerous. You're brainwashed, you're in the coke. All these things are going to be on the menu more, you know. But we are used to that, you know. That doesn't affect us, because we're going to continue to push forth this word. Rather, people hear it or forbear it, you know. Even if our nation of our people hear it or forbear it, you know. Hey, even if we prophesy unto the wind, hey, the word's still going to go out, you know. And we're going to continue to prophesy. We're going to continue to be out here on the highways and byways, whether people like it or not, or accept it, you know, accept it or not. It is what it is, you know. We're going to continue to move forward, you know. So these scoffers and mockers are not going to take us off of what we are doing, you know, and fighting for our salvation, you know, and fighting for our nation, you know. As us being the children of Israel, the lost sheep of the house of Israel, the 12 tribes of Israel, you know. Hey, we're going to keep on prophesying. Hey, we're going to continue to endure this hardness as a good soldier for Hamashiach to have a shot in the latter days, whether people like it or not. But then people in our own nation scoff and mock, or the other nations laugh and scoff and mock, like think we are crazy. Like the scripture says, we're going to be a spectacle unto all the nations, you know. And hey, we are fine with that, you know. So I just want to add a note to that, you know. Dark-skinned and complected people, you know.
those are the judges, you know. And we are descendants of those judges, of the Israelites, you know, of dark skin complexion, you know. So he paints the likeness of his image. Like, that's why the scripture says the God of this world has blinded the minds of the people. You know, that's why people are proud and arrogant and stuff like that. And they are despisers of those that are good, you know. Like when the scripture says, when a poor man speak, people despise it. But when a rich man speak, people listen, you know. And that's what's happening in a lot of days. And this is going to continue to occur in a lot of days as well, too. So that 2 Timothy, the third chapter, is definitely coming to full fruition. And that's what we've seen, you know. And I'm going back to verse 1 again for edification's sake. And this is 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1. This note also that in the last days perilous times should come. Verse 2, 2 Timothy 3 and 2. It says, for men shall be lovers of themselves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemous, disobedient, to parents, unthankful, and unholy. 2 Timothy 3 and 3, and agrees to the Holy Scripture. It says, without natural affection, true words, false accusers, incompetent, fierce, despiser of those that are good, right? Despiser of those that are good. Hey, we're going to see that continue increasing in the latter days. They're going to despise of those that are good, you know. In verse 4, it says 2 Timothy 3 and 4, traitors, hideous, high-minded, lovers of pleasure more than the lovers of your house, right? Lovers of pleasure more than the lovers of your house, you know. It says, 2 Timothy 3 and 5, having a form of godliness, but denying the powers thereof, but such turning away. So in the 2 Timothy, the 3rd chapter, all the way down to the 5th verse, hey, we're going to continue to see that a lot. Rejuvenate the American dollar as of being a top global currency reserve for decades. You know, that's not going to be the case, you know, because we've been seeing this going on as of lately. The version out of Babylon is on the decline now, so more than ever. So it doesn't matter if they come with some type of grievance and trying to bounce back with this whole country and society and stuff like that. Hey, we want to continue to see waves of the version out of Babylon on the decline now, so more than ever, you know. So, like the scripture says, Babylon having a golden cup in the Lord's hand, you know, and made all the nations drunken, you know. So the nations are turning away from the version of Babylon. They're not hip to their Western mindset. They're not hip to their economics. They're not hip up to their lifestyles, or their Western mindset lifestyles, no more. You know, so the nations have drunken all the wine off of them. So the nations are angry at man at the version of Babylon. Now, so more than ever, you know. Hey, they're going to continue to be angry at man at the version of Babylon from a warlike standpoint, from an economic standpoint. That's why the nations are turning away from the American dollar as of late. You know, so far this year, 2023, definitely as of last month, is well too, you know. So we're going to continue to see the downfall of the version of Babylon, and we're going to continue to see the increasing of these nations going to be angry at the man at the version of Babylon. So, version out of Babylon having they go to come to the Lord's hand, not anymore, you know. So we're definitely going to continue to see the downfall of this great kingdom, which is Babylon the Great, you know, modern day Egypt.
seen to see this place on the climb. Even if they try to bounce back, you know, that still doesn't matter. Hey, we're going to continue to see this place on the collapse. And on the decline as well, too. Why the men of the Lord out here on the highways and byways that she places home. And wherever we at over here in the virgin daughter of Babylon, hey, we're going to continue to chat down Babylon. The more we continue to chant down Babylon by the words of Yahweh Hashem El Shai, the more we're going to see it take full effect of this great kingdom that is going to be on the decline now, so more than ever. And this is the book of Jeremiah, chapter 51 and verse 8. It says, Babylon is suddenly fallen, and destroy out for her, take balm for her pain, and so she may be healed. Right, so there's no healing for her, not a Babylon. Have healed Babylon, but she cannot be healed. So there's gonna be no healing for this place. It's gonna be a continued downfall. It's gonna be a continued increase in decline now, so more than ever. Hey, so Babylon having a golden cup in his hand, not anymore. So hey, we're gonna continue to see this place on the downfall, on the decline. Even if they try to make alternative ways and maneuvers to bounce back in this kingdom, hey, this kingdom is gonna continue to decline. And this is the virgin daughter of Babylon, they got so many enemies, you know. Even their allies are enemies against them, you know. So that shows you that the virgin daughter of Babylon is crumbling. And it doesn't matter who be the next president, you know. So it still doesn't matter, you know. I'm trying to bounce back and just make the virgin daughter of Babylon ready, and it's not gonna happen that way. Because Babylon is very happy to go to cup in the Lord's hand, you know. Hey, Yahweh now shot taking that golden cup from the virgin daughter Babylon. So it's going to be a continued increasing downfall and decline of this great kingdom, you know. So the man of the Lord of Yahweh now shot is going to keep on chanting down Babylon by the words of the Holy Scripture, by Yahweh now shot, and continue the nation's going to continue to be angry at man at this great kingdom, you know. And this is Jeremiah chapter 51 and verse 9. We would have healed Babylon, but she is not healed. Forsaken her, and let us go everyone into his own country. For her judgments reach unto heaven, and is lifted up even to the sky. Right, because her judgments have lifted up even to the sky. The iniquities, the evilness, the wickedness, and the unrighteousness of what the virgin daughter of Babylon have reported around the world. So the nations are angry at man at the virgin daughter of Babylon. So this place can get destroyed spiritually. Many different other ways this place is going to find out some more better. According to Revelation 18 and 1 through verse 2. So that shows a prime example. There's no healing for the virgin daughter of Babylon now, so more than ever. This place is going to be on a continued decline. And this is Revelation chapter 18 and verse 1 through the verse of the Holy Scripture. It says, and after these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven, having great power. And the earth was lightened with his glory. This is Revelation chapter 18, verse 2, in the verse of the Holy Scripture. And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon is falling, Babylon is falling. It has become a habitation of deceivers, and a home of every foul spirit, and a cage of every unclean, and H-A-T-E-F-U-L-L bird. Right. So, that shows the prime examples of the virgin daughter of Babylon is falling down some more than ever, you know. Now, I'm going to switch up the spirit. So, hey, as those scriptures that I just brought out, that shows you clear examples that the virgin daughter of Babylon is definitely on the decline now some more than ever. And this is, I'm going to switch up the spirit going to the MOTB. And this is Revelation chapter 13 and verse 16. It says, and because of all, both small and great, and rich and poor, for the bond to receive that M-A-R-K, which is of the rock, in their R-I-G-H-T-H-A-N-E, or in their F-O-R-E-H-A-D-S. Right, even if you are rich and poor, for your bond to receive that M-A-R-K, which is the upper part of your body and the lighter part of your body, you know, this is going to be a new form of currency. This is that central digital bank currency, right along with Fed now as well too. So this is, we're getting closer to the book of Revelation, you know. And this is a major prophecy that's about to be fulfilled very soon, you know. So that's why we tell the children in Israel to not take that MOTB of that Quran of this current AST system, you know. That's why they're pushing for that artificial intelligence That's why they're pushing for that 2030 agenda. You know, now so more than ever, it's going to come down to great gravity than we have in a short time. And this is Revelation chapter 13, verse 17. It says that, and that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the M-A-R-K, which is the Quran, or the number of the B-E-A-S-T, which is his current system. It says, or the number of his name, right? In order to buy or sell, hey, you gotta have that that technology stored in S-C-H-I-V. This is what's coming, you know, very soon. So we're getting closer and closer to that now, so more than ever. And this is a major prophecy that's about to be made very soon, you know. So we, the men of the Lord, are going to consistently teach about this and prophesy about this. And this is a major prophecy that's about to be made very soon. So that's why we tell the church of Israel, do not take that CHIV, do not take that mark, you know. I mean that M-A-R-K, which is that Karak, you know, in order to buy or sell. So we got to have our faith and love and trust in Yahweh now. He says, I'm going to read it again for edification's sake. This is Revelation chapter 13, verse 17. It says, and that no man might buy or sell, say he had the M-A-R-K, or the name of the E-A-S-T, or the number of his name. Right. Like I mentioned again, in order to buy or sell, you know, you got to have that C-H-I-P stored in. Revelation 12 and 12 says the ultimate deceiver should come down with great gravity when we have a short term. That's why he's pushing for that artificial intelligence, depopulating humanity, continuing chemtrails in the skies and stuff like that. You know, defile this whole world, defile this land, you know, this world too. So he's going to come down with great gravity when we have a short term. Revelation chapter 13, verse 18. Here is wisdom that we have to understand. Third angel followed them, saying, with a loud voice. If any man worship the M-A-S-T in his image and receive his M-A-R-K, which is Pilate, soon to come, in his F-O-R-T-H-A-D-E, which is the upper part of his body, or in his hand, which is the right part of your body. And this is Revelation 14 and 10, and it reads the quote scripture. It says, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of the hour, which power out without mixture into the cup of his indignation, and shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. Right, so we definitely want to take that, you know. Definitely want to take that. So that shows the prime example. If you worship the image of this M-A-R-K, of this current B-E-A-S-T system, you know, and take that C-H-I-P, which is that M-A-R-K of that Moroccan, soon to come, as those Israelites, you know, you're not supposed to take that, which is the upper part of your body and the water part of your body. If you take that, if you worship this image and take that M-A-R-K, you know, you're going to get hit with fire and brimstone, and we don't want to taste that, you know. So we got to come back into the ways of how I should outside and not the ways of this world, you know. It's like it says in 1 John 2 and 2, which I'm about to bring out. So it's definitely important. It's definitely important to come out of the way of the first God of Babylon and be not compliant to the BMS system and not take that MARK to that Bible. First John chapter 2 verse 15, and it reads the whole scripture. It says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, he may love the Father, not his. Right, so can we not love the ways of this world, of the affairs and the cares of this lifestyle, or of being immersed out of Babylon, or whatever we may be scattered at, as Israelites, you know. So we cannot love the ways of this world, be not conformed to the ways of this world, but the renewing of our mind. You read that in Romans 22, 22. So we gotta come back into the ways of God, washing down the body. So, just like the scripture says, James 8, and double nine of man is unstable in all his ways. So, following the ways of this world and loving to have a problem, so we got sin to have a shot. And that's unbalanced, that's unstable. So, it's best to trust in the balanced, righteous ways of God, washing down the shot. And be not conformed to the ways of this world from a spiritual sense. You know, from a mental sense, a spiritual sense. Thank you. expansion is gonna come because we are living in those end times, you know. We're seeing definitely signs of it. That's why I mentioned countless of times, hey, we're living out the book of Revelations now, so more than ever. And it's that MOTB of this major prophecy that's about to be fulfilled. So that's why we tell the children of Israel to not take that MOTB of that Colossus, you know. Coming back to the righteous ways of the Yahweh Shem El Shai, you know. I got that Romans 13:11. And this is the book of Romans, chapter 13, verse 11, in the Greek of the Holy Scripture. And that knowing the time, that now is high time that God is sleeping. For now is our salvation, therefore we believe. Right, so now is high time that God is sleeping. Children of Israel, the lost sheep of the house of Israel, the 12 tribes of Israel, come back of you being an Israelite, coming back into the ways of righteousness. You know, of your Yahweh Shem El Shai. You know, that's why we're out here for salvation. We're out here fighting for the elect. We are out here for fishes of men. You know, that one third preserved remnant of your Yahweh Shem El Shai is going to save the cloud of age. So that's why we are out here for fishes of men. Tell the Israelite man, come back into the ways of righteousness. Acknowledge that you are an Israelite. Acknowledge that you are the sons of the Most High, Yahshua Allah. He is the Prince of Power. You are the Prince. You are a Prince of the Most High. You know, that's a powerful thing. So coming back into the ways of righteousness. That's why we tell the Israelite man, come out of the ways of this world, mentally and spiritually. You know, of course we're going to be in the society, no doubt about it. But like mentally and spiritually, you cannot be of the ways of this world, you know, like it says, you know, the wisdom of this world, the wisdom of this world is foolishness in the sight of the Heavenly Father, the Hour of Israel, you know. So that shows a prime example. You cannot be of this world. The ways of this world is upside down, keeping us in the way backwards. It's not fully 100% righteousness in this world, you know. Especially avoiding the folks that have a good lifestyle. They push that on our nation. On our women, on our men, on our children and stuff like that, you know, and our nation of our kids and the schools of these African lifestyles, the teachers pushing that it's okay to have two fathers, it's okay to have two mothers, you know, backwards and upside down, that should have a problem. So, you know, we can't follow the ways of this world, you know, especially the ways of learning about the Bible. Coming back into the ways of the Yahweh Shem El Shai, the righteous path, the righteous way, you know.
Power, so once we acknowledge our lives, you know. So with that, hopefully this lesson was edifying on the highways and byways for Chief Lesson Concourse on this Monday afternoon at 3:20 p.m. Central Time. On this Monday, May 29th, 2023, like I mentioned again, on this Monday afternoon. So hopefully this lesson was edifying out here on the highways and byways of Chief Lesson Concourse. And so with that, I would like to give all praise and support and honor to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai Bashem, and Hakadash. Shalom to the elders of Great Mills, the official words of the Institute. In the names of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai Bashem, and Hakadash, I say shalom to the elders of Great Mills. And shalom to the Akim, scattered before the winds of the globe, official words of the Institute. In the names of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai Bashem, and Hakadash. And until next time, I will say shalom.